In optical coherence tomography, light beams are directed into tissue and reflections coming from different layers are received by a detector and are processed to generate a two-dimensional image. The technology is similar to ultrasound, except that light is used instead of sound. Cross-sectional imaging with OCT, which has evolved into the state-of-the-art technology for retinal diagnostics, is now also available for the anterior eye segment. A specialized light source allows fast and high-resolution scanning of the anterior chamber and even penetrates into turbid tissue, such as the sclera and opaque corneas. Being a non-contact method, there is no need for specific preparation of the patient.
With increasing expectations of the outcomes of refractive surgery, as well as the growing range of refractive surgery procedures, anterior segment imaging and biometry is getting more and more important. Optical coherence tomography is a promising technology not only in this field, but also for general anterior segment surgery and glaucoma assessment. The following cases from my clinical practice show the capabilities of this technology for both pre-op planning and post-operative care.
Prior to laser refractive surgery, the pachymetry map obtained by a rotating OCT scan shows at first sight whether the patient's corneal thickness is sufficient or not. The precision of this technology is provenly higher than that of ultrasound and slit scanning techniques, thus providing higher confidence in the measured results. This particular patient had a refractive error of minus 4.25 diopters, combined with an astigmatism of 0.5 diopters, 150 degrees. Centrally, the OCT measured a corneal thickness of 564 microns, and the map showed no suspicious pattern, so the patient was a candidate for laser ablation. In the post-operative pachymetry map, the ablation zone is clearly visible. By subtracting this map from the pre-op pachymetry map, the ablation profile can be evaluated. In this particular case, the actual ablation, as determined by the OCT, was 71 microns centrally. In a high-resolution scan of the cornea, the flap interface can be detected. Measuring the flap and residual stromal thickness yields the information whether future enhancements are feasible. According to FDA study data, the Carl Zeiss Meditech anterior segment OCT measures corneal thickness about 15 microns thinner than ultrasound. The central and peripheral measurements have a standard deviation of 7 microns and 14 microns respectively. 95% of the LASIK flaps can be detected in the OCT images at 6 months postoperatively. Flap and residual stroma were measured with a standard deviation of less than 9 microns and 11 microns respectively. Laser refractive surgery is the method of choice for most patients. However, for those patients with a thin cornea or too high myopia, phakic IOLs have evolved into a good alternative. These implants require an exact preoperative measurement of the anterior chamber dimensions to prevent complications such as endothelial cell degeneration, pigment dispersion, or induced cataract formation. This patient had a refractive error of minus 6.25 diopters. Anterior chamber depth was 3.05 millimeters, and the iris appeared sufficiently flat in the OCT scan, so a varicized lens was chosen for implantation. In the post-operative evaluation, the OCT scan shows sufficient distances between the phakic IOL and the endothelium and to the crystalline lens. Another patient who had undergone Artiflex 1 lens implantation developed pigment dispersion and posterior synechiae. An examination with the anterior segment OCT showed that the iris was sandwiched between the phakic IOL and the crystalline lens. Different technologies for anterior segment biometry are currently evaluated in a comparative study conducted at the University Eye Clinic in Frankfurt. preliminary results of this study include that the anterior segment OCT measures the anterior chamber depth 0.17 millimeters larger than orb scan. With the OCT system, the anterior chamber width is measured directly. The values determined with this technology are 0.7 millimeters and 0.4 millimeters larger than the white-to-white measurements of OrbScan and IOL Master, respectively.
In refractive surgery with phakic IOLs, a sophisticated anterior chamber imaging and measuring tool is mandatory to minimize the risk of the complications which go along with these procedures. Particularly for the correct sizing of phakic IOLs, the OCT enables a direct measurement of the anterior chamber diameter to be done rather than white-to-white. Furthermore, evaluating the anterior chamber in different stages of accommodation, which is feasible with the OCT, gives me important information on the anatomical changes. Optical coherence tomography for the anterior eye segment is a promising technology which will emerge to be used in various clinical applications. In my practice, I found this technology superior over ultrasound because it is non-contact and has high resolution. In Scheimpflug imaging, which is an alternative technology, sensitive intraocular structures are overexposed, so direct measurements cannot be taken with appropriate accuracy. In OCT, the anterior chamber features can be measured directly with high precision, giving me the confidence I need for pre-surgical planning and for optimum post-operative care.